Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of AdMail. This is Adam Bergman, founder and CEO of IRA Financial. I'm here to help you find the answers to the most frequently asked questions from my clients about self-directed retirement accounts. If you want to learn more, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on social media. Just search IRA Financial. Hi everybody, and welcome to another episode of AdMail. I'm Adam Bergman, tax attorney and founder of IRA Financial. On today's podcast, Prohibited Transaction, episode number 9, we're going to go through three superb questions on the topic of the prohibited transaction rules. And this is going to be a fun one, some really good questions, one involving doing a joint venture between an IRA and a Roth, another one potentially doing a restructuring of a self-directed IRA into a solo 401k to do a loan. Is that allowed? And then potentially buying very, very low-valued cryptos in a Roth IRA. And how does that work? And what's the tax advantage? So I think this is going to be a really fun episode. So without further ado, let's get started. First question is from Wendy F. Wendy wants to know, hi, I have a self-directed IRA and a self-directed Roth IRA. Can I do a joint venture with the two self-directed IRAs? And the answer is yes. Under 4975C, a IRA is not deemed a disqualified person. So if you look at 4975E2, a IRA is not disqualified. An individual IRA owner is, lineal descendants, entities controlled by such persons are disqualified. But technically, IRAs are not disqualified to each other. So yes, you can technically, assuming there is equilibrium in the pricing, fair value being attributed to each IRA, you can do a joint venture between an IRA and a Roth IRA, whether it's through an entity like an LLC, or whether it's just a retitled investment where the title of the investment is in the IRA, as well as the Roth, or maybe it's property. All those are workable. Again, you just want to make sure each IRA is paying fair value, and there's not shifting of any value to one IRA versus the other. But yes, under 4975E2, as of now, an IRA is not deemed a disqualified person. There was some chatter about this in the Build Back Better bill of 2021, which didn't pass. So who knows? I mean, it's something the IRS has talked about. It's been put on the shelf, so the IRS can always reach out and try to stick it into a bill down the road. But I'm not sure it's of utter importance at this point. So as of now, Wendy, you can do a joint deal between your IRA and a Roth. Second question from Steve S. Steve wants to know, I have a self-directed IRA and want to invest in a business I control and will own over 50%. Would the following solution work? Set up a self-directed solo 401k for my new business, and enroll the IRA funds to the new 401k tax-free, and then do a loan to use the funds for the business. Well, looks like you have been listening to my podcast, watching my videos, reading my books, because that's exactly what I would say. If you need less than 50K, the solo 401k loan, a great, great option for getting tax-free penalty for use of the money to invest in a business you own personally, right? If you are going to need more than 50K and are going to control the business, which you mentioned you would, Steve, then the solo K probably wouldn't be enough of a help. And you'd probably, need to do a ROBS, a rollover business startup solution. That would allow you to set up a corporation. The corporation would adopt a 401k. The 401k would then buy stock in the corporation, which is known as the rollover business startup solution, taking advantage of an exception under 4975D13 to get around the prohibited transaction rules under 4975C, which would allow you to use all your IRA money and roll it over into the 401k structure, and then have the 401k send that money to the corporation in return for C-Corp stock, and you'd be able to be an employee, be the president, and also have your retirement account own more than 50% of the business without triggering the prohibited transaction rule. So that would be a great, great, great solution if you needed to control the business and would need more than 50K of startup capital. But if you need less than 50K, the loan is a great solution. It's a really viable option. A couple things to keep in mind. It is a loan, so you're gonna have to pay that back over 5 years, at least quarterly. As of September 2020, four interest rate prime is 8.5%. Although if rates drop, it would be reduced accordingly. So that is an interest rate you have to pay back. It's a straight line loan. It's not a balloon loan. The good news is you're paying your plan back. So essentially on $50,000, it's getting an 8.5% rate of return, which is pretty cool. And you get tax-free penalty for use of the money. Use it for any purpose, Steve, including funding your own business. And this way you get to control your business personally, own it outside of the retirement account, but use retirement money tax-free penalty free to fund it. So a pretty cool solution. I think you got it, Steve. You can pretty much take my job. Good job. great work. A third and final question of today's podcast from Larry R. Larry wants to know, I have a friend who can sell me a new crypto token for about one penny. Could I buy that in a self-directed Roth IRA and then all the gains would be tax-free? So yes, technically, Larry, the friend is not disqualified. So you're able to transact with a friend, assuming your IRA is paying fair value for the token. Then yes, if you keep the token in a Roth IRA, I assume you'd buy in a Roth since it's probably an expensive token. And it went up from a penny to, I don't know, 3 pennies or 5 pennies. And you sold it, all the money would go back tax-free to the Roth IRA. But you'd have to wait till you're 59 and a half and the Roth's been open at least 5 years to use those funds, you know, and live off the money. But even if you're under 59 and a half, all the gains can roll back to the IRA, the Roth tax-free, penalty-free, and then you can reinvest it, right? You can buy stocks or real estate or more cryptos or gold or private business stock or private investments, whatever you want. And all as long as that money's in the Roth family, it's all going to be tax-free, which is pretty, obviously pretty tax advantageous and very exciting. So yes, you can do it. Your friend is not disqualified. So you are free to transact with your friend. Just make sure it's a fair, reasonable deal, and the IRA is paying fair value for what it's buying. Otherwise, that's it for today's podcast. Thanks to Wendy, Steve, Larry. Three great questions. It's a great podcast if you want to get really to the point, short and succinct and detailed answers to three, I think, very top questions. Next week's will be the last prohibitive transaction episode in the 10-part series. Then I'll probably move on to UBIT, but you know, check in every week for the podcast because you're going to learn something. And I try to keep these podcasts like under 8 minutes, pretty short and sweet. So we all can learn from each other and become more successful, better, smarter, and hopefully richer self-directed investors. That's it for today's podcast. Appreciate your support. If you haven't subscribed already, please do. This is a weekly podcast. If you want to watch it, you can do it on our amazing YouTube IRA Financial channel. That's it. Have a great day, and I'll see everyone again next week. Thanks.